Welcome to another Working Out with Aaron Briggs video. Aaron, what's up for today?
Yeah, you can see on the title card, today is cardio and it's about 10 minutes. We're gonna go total body and this one's gonna be a little bit different than what you might be thinking. This is our, we call our animal moves day. Our kiddos just love this one and anytime I've done it with adults, they air quotes love it too. It's a challenging one. So like we always do, we're gonna invite you to warm up with us by doing the same movements we're gonna do for our workout. And again, reminder that you don't even have to know what it's called. If you can see us and you can mimic what we're doing, just get kind of close. That being said, this is called our bear walk or our bear move. And the idea is that you're kind of in that down dog position and just kind of taking some steps. Second move is what's called a frog. And this is really just a squat, okay? But it's kind of a frog hop. And you can see, again, if you have a little trouble with doing this one, you put your hands on the ground and you're really just kind of moving your feet and hands forward and backward as a pair, right? So like my hands move up together and then my legs move up together, put a little weight on my hands. You can totally step up instead of doing a little hop. We always want that to be kind of an option for you. And again, we'll keep exploring that as we keep going. Our third move is a crab walk. Take yourself back to middle school.
Yeah, back to grade elementary school, yeah. Second grade.
Yeah, now this one is a great one for us, especially the higher you get your hips, it gets to be super challenging if you want it to be that way. The note on this is that it can also be a little hard on those wrists. So again, be prepared to take breaks, sit down if you need to. And then our last move is called our monkey shuffle or our monkey hop. And it's really similar to that frog. You're kind of, you know, on your hands, then you're moving your feet as a pair, or even just doing a little side step, a side shuffle. And the idea is, again, you're just, it's more like mobility plus some what we call floor strength. You're just getting good at moving around on the floor a little bit. And yeah, the idea here is to have fun. It's gonna be a little silly. It's going to be quite challenging if you're not ready for it. And we hope you enjoy this one with us. Mm-hmm. Okay, so warm-up's done. Those are our four movements. And for my people that love to know kind of the whole plan here, the idea is that we're gonna do those four movements, but for 60 seconds each. So it's gonna be a 4-minute circuit and we're doing two full circuits today for a grand total of about 8 minutes of stopwatch time. 4, 3, 2, 1, let's begin. Now keep in mind, I always include my warm-up time and my cool-down time.
So yeah.
Really, this is, yeah. It falls between an 8 and like a 13-minute workout. I think we say 10 just for the ease of use of it here. But yeah, it's gonna be a good workout. Especially if you haven't been used to doing this before or you're not used to doing this, 60 seconds in a bear walk can be a long time. So again, remember, take breaks. This is less about strength and more about what we call cardio. We want your heart rate elevated. We want you feeling like you're breathing a little bit. And you don't have to experience a lot of fatigue. If your shoulders or legs are getting really tired here, take a break. It's totally fine, right? Take three breaths and get back into it.
Yeah, as we kind of say in all of our videos, it's always about looking and feeling good.
Absolutely.
So if one of these moves or this one in particular causes something to kind of twinge or you're like, ooh, I don't know if that's supposed to feel that way.
5 seconds.
For sure, just switch it up and take care of that. Make sure that you're not doing anything that hurts.
Very good. Let's get into frog hops. Okay, and the thing to remember with frog hops like that, like those bear walks, is it's your first time. Your goal here is just to move well and to make sure that you feel good. So again, just pay attention. Now, both Maggie and I have decent hip flexibility. We can sit fairly low into that squat. If that's not you, that's totally fine. You keep your hips as high as they need to be and even just do a little forward shuffle. Mm-hmm. Again, it's really practicing your ability to kind of squat and move within a squat pattern here. Mm-hmm. It's great for us to be able to move this way. It adds to your strength. It also adds to your ability to, I'll say, look good as we start to tone those muscles. It especially adds to your ability to feel good.
Right? Yeah.
We're talking about those kind of main goals that people have. And this is a great way to be strong. Oh.
Yeah, it's one of those where we talk about how you don't necessarily need to do like a whole 30-minute workout of core. Like,
no.
This is one of those that uses the whole body.
3, 2, 1, shift into crab walks.
Including the core.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, and then on these crab walks, again, one thing that I wanna draw your attention to, not just with the crab walks, but with all of these exercises, Mags and I are on our living room rug. It's not a ton of space, and that's the idea with these particular movements is if you have a yoga mat, you can do all of these.
If you literally just have a flat space on the floor, you can do it. I mean, you can do it outside. in the grass.
Sure.
With your kiddos.
Yeah. Well, we were talking about that as we were even doing this, is this is a great one to involve your kiddos in because they tend to do this anyways.
And yeah.
We've done this workout with them and they love it. They absolutely love it.
Yeah, and again, we never call it a workout. No. We just say, hey, let's go downstairs and do some animals. Let's pretend to be animals. And we crank up some fun music. And then, you know, especially on those rainy days or winter dark days when they just have a lot of energy and they...
No, 5 seconds.
And it's a game for them. It's really fun.
2, 1, and let's get into that monkey position. Remember, it's a lot like that frog. You're going to be in that squat. And the difference now is instead of forward and backward, you're just going side to side. And again, after that crab, remember, for a lot of people, that can be, it makes their wrist tight, right? And kind of add some, it's like it compresses a little bit. So here's your spot to deload those wrists for a little while. You'll see me occasionally shake my hands out. If I needed to take a break and kind of stretch those, I could do that too, right? Okay, so you've got about 30 seconds left, and I'm gonna go ahead and forecast for you what's coming up. Remember, with cardio, we try not to take long breaks here. Now, I keep mentioning, take breaks wherever you need, and I totally want you to do that. I always use my 3-breath rule. If I get tired, I just stop what I'm doing and I take 3 deep breaths.
Yeah, and then you just kind of jump right back into it. Yeah, so at the end of this movement, we are going to jump right back into that bear crawl. So there really isn't a built-in break, but if you do need one, go ahead. Oh, 3, 2, 1. Sorry, guys. Go ahead and start that bear crawl. If you do need a little break, feel free to just, I think even I took a couple minutes here to, or not a minute, but a couple breaths to just kind of like, oof, okay, that was round one. This is round two. Here we go. I can do this. Like kind of mentally get into it again and say like, all right, this is mind over matter at this point. My muscles are kind of burning, but I can keep going.
Now, one thing that I'm gonna, if you want to look at the screen, for those of you that it just, the animal moves feel a little silly, I get it. And it's totally fine. You don't have to do that. As much as I always think in my mind, oh, I hope somebody walks in on you right now, right? Just so you can do that. But if you'd like to convert these into more exercises instead of kind of the animal moves, you can watch me on these because it's actually more of the exercise thing. I'm actually just doing what we call a plank around the world. I'm lifting one arm, one leg up, and I'm not actually having to walk. 3, 2, 1. Let's switch to those frog hops. And again, if you're gonna follow me here and not do a frog movement, all this is a what we call a squat to stretch. I'm squatting down low and then I'm standing back up. It's great for mobility and whoo, it started to burn those quads a little bit.
Yeah, for sure, it was great.
So again, if the movements themselves feel just a little silly, you can always convert it back into an exercise pattern for yourself. I get that. I am one of those people, I don't like a lot of attention on me, so I imagine if I was doing this outside, people would be like, what the heck is he doing?
Yeah, but that's one of the beauties of doing this on a video. Yeah. If you're at home, you might be doing it at a video someday in the future at a gym or something, but right now you might be at your house and maybe the only people watching is your family and you could say, hey, you try it. It's harder than it looks.
Yep. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and move into that crab position. You know, it's funny, we tell you, we always want you to look and feel good. And we think, like, as far as that goes, I think safety is a big part of it, too.
Yeah.
And not only do you need to feel physically safe, but you need to feel, like, probably emotionally safe, too. Right? If you could think of yourself doing this and you're like, there's no way I would do that, I would tell you don't do it, right? I would tell you change that up a little bit so that it's something that you can and want to do. So, again, remember, there's lots of ways for you to do this and for you to have a good time with it. So again, feel free to explore. And the variation that I'm doing with the crab, instead of a crab walk, these are just called crab toe touches. And you'll, at most gyms, you'll see people doing something like this if they're doing their floor. They're still supporting themselves up and they're trying to, you know, kind of reach one hand towards the opposite toe. It's challenging to hold your balance up like that. So again, that's a nice little, you know, dialed up or dialed down version. 3, 2, 1. Last of all would be that monkey move or that side shuffle.
Yeah, I will say if you do have little ones around that you can do this with, it is very humbling. They do these moves like it is nothing.
Naturally.
It is insane how easy it is for those kiddos to do this, which is really fun. And I think it's almost telling. It's saying, hey, like, these are moves that we kind of can do with our bodies from a very young age.
Yeah,
we're supposed to be able to kind of do these things. Now, granted, our bodies change significantly as we age. But it's kind of a really fun thing to see little kids doing this. Maybe we'll try to get a shot of them doing some of these moves later today.
Yeah, absolutely.
Add those at the end.
15 seconds to go. You've done a great job. Remember, we've gone 8 minutes straight. If you throw on the little warm-up that we've done, it's closer to 10 minutes. And again, we just love that you're practicing with us. Keep it going. Strong finish. 3, 2, 1. Excellent. And now that we've done our workout, like we do with almost every workout, we add our stretch and our focus for the workout. This particular one, we're focusing on our ability to kind of bend and mobilize around the lower back, as well as stretching our core and our kind of front side muscles here, okay? So remember, we've got two key stretches. One of those is what we're doing right now, which is called a Sphinx. If you were to pop up on your hands, which we will do later, you'll see a Cobra position. And now that we've held it for about 30 seconds, we did our static stretch. We're gonna do our dynamic stretch where we add a little movement. And if you're taking a look at the screen, you'll see both Maggie and I kind of elevating our chest. I always say that I point my sternum up and out, right? It's kind of like a gentle...
Remembering to still make it feel good.
Yeah.
And then I always have to remember to release those glutes and make sure I'm not tightening my butt.
Exactly. And then this one in particular is always a bit of a funny one, but we always, at the end of a stretch, we do our what we call our posture assessment, our posture movement, just to kind of check in, and it's the same. Right?
Yeah.
So the Sphinx and the
in
and
this
the Cobra,
series, it's the same. Yeah.
It's this movement is the posture is the movement. So again, we're gonna hold this an extra 30 seconds. You'll see me dial it up into a Cobra. It felt a lot better to Sphinx do that. You know, kind of do the Sphinx first, and then I was much more flexible.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And that should do it for our stretching. We are done with our workout. Well done
today.
Way
to go, you guys. See, this was a 10-minute workout, and generally we shoot for about 25 minutes a day or 150 minutes a week. And so if you're looking for some more direction from us as far as movement goes, make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you can look at all of the videos that we have made so far. We've got, of course, more cardio videos, strength videos, even some core ones, and we also have kind of a nutrition track going on too. So make sure to check those out. We're so glad you guys are with us. Have fun and make it a great day.